At the time of going to press, NERA had not been given the go-ahead to man march 150,000 through the Central Business District of Harare to the ZEC office to hand over their petition. The excuse given by police is that 150,000 are too many to march through the Central Business District as they will disrupt traffic and the business in the business district. However, going back a few weeks, ZANU-PF men marched 1 million of their supporters through the same business district midweek. However, the same police did not say anything, which falls under the same Minister of Home Affairs, Minister Chombo. Minister Chombo starts by denouncing what he called mayhem caused by protesters burning cars and looting shops. You can hear from his tone that he is an angry man.
The government of Zimbabwe condemns in the strongest terms Western-sponsored violent protests that erupted in Harare Central Business District on the 23rd of August 2016, perpetrated by opposition political parties and their affiliate civic organizations. Protesters went on a rampage, callously damaging property and, in the process, burning vehicles and a police base, looting shops, disrupting business and the free movement of people. In light of these disturbances, I wish to remind Zimbabweans that the security ministries are mandated to maintain law and order and to protect life and property. Yesterday's mayhem and chaos in the Harare CBD disrupted business, disrupted free movement of people, destroyed property, and this is a gross violation of people's democratic rights as enshrined in the nation's constitution. The burning that took place yesterday was premeditated. Those who organized it will be made to account. As the law enforcement agents of this country, we will not be found wanting in defending the democratic rights of the Zimbabwean people. We will not tolerate any attempts by any group of persons, political parties, civic organizations, or individuals whose actions will undermine the peace and the quiet that Zimbabwe enjoys today. Those regime change agents bent on trying to remove a democratically elected government will face the full wrath of the law. As government, we are fully aware of the intentions of the opposition political parties and the various groups to court international intervention in Zimbabwe's internal affairs. This will be stopped. We can't sit idly by while our country is being torn apart by unruly foreign-sponsored agents. We want to reassure the nation that peace and tranquility will be maintained at all times. People should proceed with their business as usual. Security will be guaranteed. There is no day that people who have sought permission to go on a demonstration have done it peacefully. All the demonstrations that we have seen here in Harare were very, very violent. Actually, we want to commend the police for being so tolerant. It really, from our observations, the people that are demonstrating are trying to provoke police in order to find something to say. So let me assure you, any person that attempts to demonstrate in an unpeaceful manner will be stopped. Next. Yes.
Our minister, maybe two questions. Is it the entire government that is really in support of what you are saying, like saying we commend the police action and you are saying they may tolerate? You have seen some ministers coming out condemning the police action, saying actually the police are the one who are causing an international condemnation on Zimbabwe by their action. Is it like the entire government in support of what you are saying? Then number two,
I'll answer that first. I haven't seen any minister who said the looting and burning that took place yesterday was good. So that matter is solved. So
the police action, not the looting. The police action.
But the looting is what he invited police to take appropriate action.
But the looting happened only yesterday. All along there's no looting.
This was not yesterday only. Choppies, this is the second or the third time it has been looted.
And then the problem, my second question would be, when we came here, we found no water. And that government is putting more money on buying, you know, canisters for police action. When they, no, they actually saying that government priorities are being put on purchase of canisters.
Water or tea is just a cater that is extended to you, and don't take it for granted. Okay. It has already been withdrawn. Yes, what's your name?
My name is Shaw from Bloomberg News.
From?
Bloomberg News Agency.
What's that?
It's an American news agency.
All right. Ambassador, the other question. Who is the ambassador?
Thomas.
Ah, okay.
Morgan Sankrai, together with the first minister, said they are going ahead with the march tomorrow despite the ban by the police. What's your take on that?
I've already said we will not tolerate any illegal demonstrations. But it's very clumsy of them to try to go to court when yesterday people were looting shops and so on, and so they want to go again to court so that they can continue to loot shops tomorrow. I think we have a moral duty to protect citizens of this country. We have a moral duty to protect people that do business in the CBD area so that they are not unnecessarily disrupted by these malcontents that were running around the city yesterday.
So government, are not going to allow to demonstrate tomorrow. Is it government policy that they're not going to put? Is it government policy that tomorrow they must not march because they said they want to go to say?
No, Changirai and his henchmen in Mtasa, they don't seek permission from me. They seek permission from their district, dispo. And so if the dispo says no, then they will not march. And if they elect to march unlawfully, then they are breaking the law. The police are there to protect citizens against lawbreakers. So simple and so straightforward. Any other?
Just a follow-up on this one. My name is Chris Mahona. I like for African News Agent.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it, Minister, that the law says they only inform the police, they don't seek permission?
They won't?
They only inform the police of the intended march, not necessarily to seek permission from the police.
No, they seek permission so that they could be protected by the police because they've got certain routes that they need to follow. So the police have the capacity and they are ready to protect people that are genuinely wanting to demonstrate. But if people want to come in and cause mayhem, the police also have capacity to tell who is genuine and who is not. And their decision is final.
Kana muchida kuvewo kutanga kunzwa nyaya dzakadai mazuva ese, garai makateya pa YouTube nekuklika button rakanzi subscribe. Munobva maitawo kutanga pa ZimdiTV News kunzwa zviri kuitika.